Hello friends, thank you for watching my videos. So in previous videos I have talked about AFL fuzzer. I have shown you how do we install AFL fuzzer, then I have shown you how do we write a simple C program, and then we have seen different types of vulnerabilities like heap overflow, stack overflow, out of bound read, out of bound write, overflow, integer flow, and we have written a simple C program containing all of this vulnerability. Was that, and then we have also did root cause analysis using DB. We have used CrashWalk to triage our cache. So that was the AFL part. I will do more AFL videos in here, but meanwhile I wanted to talk about a new fuzzer which is called home fuzz, and this is also a very popular fuzzer, so I thought it will be a good idea to do a video on that so that people come to know about that, how do we use that. So in this video I'm going to talk about that, and so first thing first, let's go and see how do we install home fuzz. So home fuzz is again created by a member of Google Project Zero team, Robert Sivek. Sorry if I am not able to pronounce that properly. And so first thing we will do, we will go to the GitHub URL, we will copy the URL over here and we will clone it. So let's use our command clone. Let's wait till the repository gets found on our system. Take some. Once it's cloned, we'll try to install it. How to compile that? Generally for compilation what you can do is you can either drive it configure file or okay, it is cloned, so let's go to home first directory. Yes, you can has couple of files, but there is no directly do. So let's do a make. Filing. Okay, there is one error message. It says that fatal error bfd.h, no such file or directory. So now this issue comes when you don't have some library installed on your system, and this it seems that we need to install libutils or binutils dev package. So let's try with that. I've done some myself. If you face any such issue, just simply do a Google and you know that which library you need. So let's try installing binutils dev. Solves our issue. Hopefully this should. Let's install binutils dev. Now let's do filing. So it again says that libunwin test.h file not found. So we again need to install another lib that will be profiling. So far it's working fine. Hopefully the compilation get finished. Okay, so the point to note here is that you need to install two lib. First one is you need to install binutils dev, and the second one you install is libunwind dev. So if you are getting any of this issue, make sure you have this two library installed. Now that we have compiled Honk first, let's go and install using install. Okay, it has installed. And once you do a make install, what you will see is that like in case of AFL, you used to get AFL CC LGC. So similarly, in case of Honkfuzz, you will get HFuzz CC, HFuzz CLang, HFuzz CLang++, HFuzz GC. So this is the compiler you need to use if you want to use Honkfuzz. So let's just run one of this working. So far it is working. So now what we are going to do, we'll copy our C program from AFL directory. We'll use it as or we can. Here I am in the read file directory. I will open and show you that program that you know. So as you can see, this is the simple C program we can use it for all the our fuzzing efforts. And what it does is, so you can see over here that it has a main function which accepts two standard arguments, which is type argc and basically expect one file name as the parameter. Give one file name, what it will do is call process image function. What process does is opens that file and over here structure. This is an imaginary file structure which we have created. Start with a header of 4 bytes, has a width and height which is of type integer, and data which is of bytes character array. So this process image function will open the file name which, and it will use read file call over here. Will read the structure. It expects the file to follow this structure. It will keep reading that. Then it will do some operation like will read width and height. It will some addition, subtraction. Based on that, will allocate some it will allocate some memory. So all these are vulnerable conditions. We expect a fuzzer to find over here. There condition like C buffer overflow or divide by zero or out of bound read and write and all this thing. So let's go and compile this. We will see that how does Honkfuzz work in this. So let's use HFuzz and compile. Is compiled and not working. Error message that file doesn't exist. And now we run. So before that, let's see what kind of option run it. And so you see that it has given simple example over here. Honkfuzz I input directory. X the hyphen hyphen file name and parameter. So then with this we need to, but in this case we need to use compile time instrumentation. So what we'll do is command. So the first one you see not use any fuzzing feedback, but since we are compiled using Hong fuzz, so we need to use the compiled time instrumentation so that it can automatically discover a new pass and it mutates the file based on that. So let's go and run this command. The command we are going to use one third one, and so I is as you can see, it started executing the fuzzing process. It was actually very quick, started finding a lot of crashes. Within amounts of time, we are having like 50 crashes. We have 3 unique crashes over here. The coverage over here. And you can see over here that it is automatically finding that the crash is duplicate. So yeah, let's wait for some time and you can see over here that it has done this penetration is the mode is feedback driven mode, that it is creating the file automatically. Right now it is running only one thread, but there is option where you can run multiple threads, like you can run one master and different slaves in case of AFL. So in this case you can run multiple threads in case of Hong fuzz. Then timeouts, you can see that what it does, it waits for 1 second. If the process doesn't respond, it will mark as a timeout. See the corpus size. So current corpus size is 8. Initialization was one file only, and yeah, so it has actually found 30 caches, which I think is pretty fast. AFL has taken more time with the imaginary file. So let's go and stop the execution. So we'll see what kind of crashes we have got. I'm going to press Control C. You can see we already have 14 units over here. So let's see what kind of crashes we have. And so the thing over here is that by default it saves all the crashes in the file where in the folder where you have started the Hong fuzz command. So there are options where you can specify, but just to make things simple, I have not specified it over here. And interesting thing about Hong fuzz is that it gives you the signal name and some details over here, like stack and which is the instruction which caused the crash over here. So the file naming convention is a bit different from the AFL. So let's go and simply run our image reader with this crashes, and we'll see what kind of crashes are we getting over here. So copy this file first and see that it is giving segmentation fault. So since we have not compiled this with address sanitizer, so that's why it is segmentation fault. We are not getting further message. Go and our second crash over here.